have the guts to even look for poison to poison someone or to burn someone? Because with all the man picking the way plenty for outside, so stay shrine the chop some. With all the woman way plenty, stay shrine the chop some. Everyone, welcome again. It's your girl Melodies TV. Hope you guys are doing great. Today we are going to be handling another societal happenings, couple goals, yeah, relationship matters. Hope you guys enjoyed our previous video where our sister Aisha had to quit out of her wedding just a week after she got married because the husband's cucumber was too big for her. I hope you enjoyed that. If you haven't watched that video, you can go back. I'm going to add a link on the description box so that for those who have not watched it, they can check it out on it. And we have a lot of more videos. Today we are going to be talking about something else. That is, a lot of things are happening in our society that people take for granted. People take for granted, and then people lose their lives in the course of it. It's like when we don't talk about it, or when we don't get the right counseling, we keep doing one and the same mistakes every day. You can't be preparing for your wedding, okay? And then your ex is calling you to come over so that you guys can have a one-night stand or retirement benefit. I don't know how I can put it. I don't know if it's retirement benefit some of us are going to collect, or is a goodbye kiss, or a goodbye kandada if you want to go and knock. Hello. You are preparing for your wedding. This guy has to lose his life because his ex invited him over so that they can eat and drink and even give the last kiss or the last kanda to knack. Just imagine, come to think of it. You like me that much that we could not marry, but you want further to marry another person after dating me and leaving me. And then I'm inviting you and you are coming over. A guy has dated you, did not marry you, maybe move on with another relationship. And when he gets to know that you are getting married, he starts contacting you again. Few days to your wedding, he tells you he wants to see you over. That should be a red flag to you. As a human, you should think, there is no way. See, the truth about life is, there is no man you have dated before, and then you hear that person is getting married and you are like, oh, let him move on. That other part, we are all humans. There is a point in time you feel like, oh, really, he's getting married. Even though you are happy for him, maybe you have moved on with your life, but there is still that human nature in you, that there is a little bit of jealousy in you, like he's getting married or she's getting married. Now, this guy is getting married. In a week time, his ex invite him over for a drink and food. And at the end of the day, do you know what they will do? He went over to see her, left his fiance home or wherever she was, went over to see her. They ate, they drank together. She poisoned the drink both of them took. He had to die, and she died as well. They were found both lifeless in his car. After a lot of things have happened, there is no way. What did he even tell you, or what did she tell you to convince you to come over? These are some of the things we should avoid. It's not only about your ex or only about girlfriend, even friends. There are some gatherings you should avoid when you are at the verge of doing something that is meaningful to your life. When you are about to get married, there are some gatherings you should avoid. There are some friends you should avoid. There are some people you should avoid until everything has come to pass. There are some people you will just meet, they will tell you only one thing and you will quit that wedding. There is nothing, nothing, there is nothing to justify this, that you move to see your ex few days to your wedding because he or she invited you over to come and that you should have a drink. Which drink? The drink you people have been drinking before he left you or she left you, or which drink are you talking about? Come to think of it, what drink are you talking about? Now, to me, the only victim in this situation is his fiancée, that he must have told her one big lie before going out. She's the only victim. This should be a lesson to all of us. This should be an eye-opener to us all. It's not funny to me, it's not joke to me that few days to your wedding, you are popping out to visit your ex, whether he or she. How does it sound to you? No matter how connected you guys are, no matter how you guys discuss, let that person be. If it is any discussion that you guys cannot handle it on phone, don't go. It's uncalled for. If there is anything he or she wants to tell you, let that person put it through on the phone. It is for your own good. It is for our own good. You are doing yourself good and doing that person good. Because that little jealousy in every human being is in us. Sincerely, now he is dead. She is dead. The worst of it is that she poisoned even her own and end their life. See how beautiful she is. Beautiful girl, handsome boy. It is even better for that girl because at the end of the day, they didn't get married, so she's not even a widow. She lose her ex. He's still her ex. She'll move on with her life. She'll get another relationship. But you lose your life because of food and drink and small udu pyo pyo. She has just given, maybe you give only one mop. One mop. After one mop, you lose your life. A second sweet. Small sweet way call you good because even your psychology you could not even handle it because you just do it to please her. You just do the thing 1, 2, 3 and you are out. How many second man you are out because you want to drink? You are doing senof. Or is it senof, or how should I put it? It is retirement benefits, right? Stay off your ex once you are preparing for your marriage. Even when you are having a serious relationship, there are sometimes you guys can talk because not every relationship ended poorly. Some relationships ended happily that you guys accept the fact that it is not working for us. It cannot work. Let's go separate way. You are doing fine. He is doing fine. Both of you are doing fine. You guys communicate. Yeah, that is different. But at that peak of your marriage, of your wedding, you guys can communicate on phone. Because come to think of it, what if you sit there and your bride-to-be or your groom-to-be happens to meet you in an uncompromised situation, position with your ex? What do you think will come into his or her head? They start thinking that, oh, it means you guys are already having an affair. It means you guys never separated. She loved you that much. He loved you that much to invite you just at the peak of your wedding. That was so tempting. That is temptation. Stay off such temptation. It's uncalled for. Stay off such temptation. I saw a similar thing happen a few years ago that this girl was about to get married and the ex-boyfriend invited her that he just want her to come, that they should talk about it, that he's happy for her. She should just come. She went and met this guy, and this guy poured petrol on her and burned her. She was rushed to the hospital, but she couldn't make it, and this guy moved out of town. Who is at the losing end? Her family, her husband-to-be is crying. But we can avoid situations like this by not going at all. by avoiding such a gathering. It is uncalled for. Even some friends, there are some friends you should avoid when you are preparing for your wedding. You know your friends. You know some of the things they tell you. We know each and every one of us. Just stay off them until after your wedding. Then you guys can talk. If, in short, any discussion at that period that cannot be handled on phone is uncalled for. Tell me whatever you want to tell me on phone. Tell me whatever you want to tell me on phone. There is no need for any retirement benefit. There is no need for any one last time. How many seconds of sweet? There is no need for that. Was she that sweet and you could not keep her? Or was he that good in bed and he could not keep you? No. We need to see things like this and avoid. A lot of us are still making mistakes like this, and we need to talk about it so that even our kids, our young ones, can listen and understand that this thing has consequences. Some will invite you peacefully, you will go there and nothing will happen. And another one will invite you and you go there and you meet problem. And you meet trouble. What will you tell yourself? Even your family will be ashamed. You will be buried in a shameful manner. That kind of corpse is frowning because of the shame and the humiliation. You went to see your ex because of one last time, because of one last kiss, because of your retirement benefit. That retirement, the one that he or she has been giving you when you guys were together, it was not enough. Stay off your ex at the verge of your marriage. The moment your ex leaves you and move on with another person, that's to tell you that he or she is done with you. Be done with them. If they didn't come back to make things work until you get into another relationship, rise to the level that this person is engaging you and planning for a marriage, it means that you were not meant for them. If, and for this girl or for this man that is killing another person because of this person is getting married, there is someone out there that will love you for who you are. There is someone out there that will give you the happiness that this person didn't give you. The fact that this person left you is because he or she is not meant for you. Someone out there will give you, pour out this love to you. You will not even struggle for it because every bem-bem pot get cover. See how some people who are even, people who cannot even walk, they can't talk, they can't do anything on their own, but they still find their soulmate. So remove that hatred, that bitterness in you that he dumped you or he left you or she left you or she dumped you for another man. Remove it from your heart. Open up and welcome a new relationship. It will help you heal very fast. It will help you heal sincerely. Let's move that bitterness, because the moment, that's to tell you that this lady had never, even the relationships that she had had after this guy, she had never loved him. She was still with this guy. And the moment you have not moved on with yourself, it is difficult for you to love another person genuinely. That is why you see a lot of relationships have, you just see your woman or your man unnecessarily nagging for nothing, reacting over minor issues, issues that people can just talk over it and it ends there. But you see them overreacting. It's not because they just want to react. They are still holding on. It's just like they are selling a goat and still holding the rope. They are still holding on to their past. Move on. Face your front. The past is your past. It was just a lesson for you to learn. It was not like to crucify you. It's your past. Move on. Because if you move on, you will not develop that hatred of taking another one's life because this person is moving on. The fact that this guy is able to propose to another woman that he wants means that he has moved on with his life. The fact that this lady is able to accept another man's ring, it means that she has moved on. You too should move on. Let's stop taking lives that we cannot make because of silly things that we because of our selfish gain, selfish interest. What do you think about her family or his family? You even have the guts to even look for poison, to poison someone or to burn someone, because with all the man picking the way plenty for outside, so stay shrine the chop some. With all the woman way plenty, stay shrine the chop some. Any man gets his own partner. Africa has made it so easy for us because it is there. Some men will get married to two or three. Eh? It is their own way. So why not stay there and wait for God's time? As we used to say that God's time is the best. If you wanted him, maybe you would have even convinced him that don't get married, it is you I want. Not to take his life and take your own life. At the end of the day, what did you gain? What did you gain, or what will you gain taking another man's life? You will gain nothing. So it makes no sense taking another man's life because this person has moved on. Lesson of this story is that no matter how good or how sweet talking that person is to you, at the verge of a very significant day in your life, all communication should end on phone. If and only if it is worth it. Because there are some people you should just block them for a while until after things are done. Because sincerely, not all ex are toxic. There are some people today who are doing well because their ex opened some doors for them. There are some people today who are happy in their marriage because their ex could see that things went down and opened some doors for them. And they move on. Not all ex are toxic. This is just an advice for us to stay off trouble. You don't know the heart of man is evil. You don't know. No matter how that person smiles, no matter how good that person is, you are getting married. Move on. May God not allow us come in contact with possessive men or possessive women that want to take our lives at the end of the day because we move on. Since some of us have decided that because this man dates me, maybe because he is your first love or is your first date, you own him. The day his father was impregnating his mother, or the day his mother got pregnant for her, they were calling by your name that this is your woman. So if he leaves you, you have the right to take his life. May God not allow us come to in contact with such people. Sincerely, may God never allow it to happen. Thank you all so much for watching. May you pray over your relationships because you don't know who you are dating. You might be dating your own enemy. Because at the end of the day, if anyone can take someone's life, means that person has been your enemy all through your relationship. There is no love in taking someone's life. No matter how you love that person, taking their life should never be an option. There is no excuse for that. There is no excuse for that. Thank you all so much for watching this clip. I hope you learned something. And if you can share this maybe to your little ones, to your peers, to your friends, I will sincerely appreciate. For those who have been here with me all through, thank you so much for showing your girl love, for staying with us. And if you are new to my channel and you like what we are doing here, please, you're free to click on that subscription button. Like this video at the end if you enjoy it. Turn on my post notifications so that when I upload new videos, you will be notified. Hope I'm going to see you again on my next upload. Bye-bye. May Konji not make you take money live. Oh.